Good evening. Myself Sangeetha Devi from G.K.Jain School, Raipuram. Today we are going to see Accountancy 12th Standard, the Chapter 1 and Accounts of from Incomplete Records. I have written only about Accounts from Incomplete Records. First we will know the meaning of Incomplete Records. What is the Incomplete Records? Whatever the records we have not completely maintaining it, we will tell it in general. General meaning of Incomplete Records, we are not maintaining the records properly. Under the double entry system, whatever the accounts we are not maintaining, we call it as incomplete records. And that also comes under the section 128 subsection 1 of Indian Companies Act 2013. Every Indian company should maintain their accounts under the double entry system. If it is not maintaining, we will tell it as incomplete records. Now we go for the meanings. Some companies will maintain their accounts properly. In the meaning, they will enter all the transaction happening in the company. From each day-to-day expenses onwards, they will maintain. From whenever we go through it, we will able to view it and get the results perfectly. Some companies will maintain their accounts partially. Some entries they will enter, some entries they will not enter. That whoever companies that is not entering properly, that comes under the incomplete records. And what in incomplete records, what they will do is, only they will enter cash and personal accounts. Cash and personal accounts alone will be entered. That also personal accounts of the customer and the creditor. For cash account they will enter, and they will enter personal account of the customer and the creditor. They will not enter any other accounts. That all comes under the incomplete records. This is the meaning of incomplete records. We are going to the features that we will learn, in limitations, whatever it is going to come. First we will learn features. The first under heading is nature. Nature. In the nature, they will not maintain anything in the systematic way. It is unsystematic and unscientific. They will not enter the transactions in the record properly. So that the nature is, they will not follow the accounting standards, accounting principles. So nothing will be followed under the incomplete records. The second point is types of account maintain. What they will maintain? They will maintain, I have told already, cash and personal accounts only they will maintain. They will not maintain any other accounts. So that all comes under the types of account maintained. Next is lack of uniformity. We have different organizations in the country. We have large scale, we have small scale, we have partnership, joint stock company. We have different organization. But some companies, maybe the name may be different, but they all will have their accounts in the proper way. But in incomplete records, it is not in the same way. They will have the different accounts to be maintained. So that comes under the lack of uniformity. It will not be same as like the other companies. Next is, financial statements may not represent true and fair view. I have told you, we have maintaining only partial accounts. So we will not get any accurate information. So that we can tell that we will not get the true profitability of the company. Every year we will prepare at the end of trading P&L balance sheet. In that time I have not entered some accounts. So I will not get the accurate result. So I cannot tell the financial statement I have given is true and fair. So that is the next point. We are moving on to the suitability. Suitability is that we have companies that will have only legally it will be following the rules of the government. That is also comes under the Indian Companies Act. Whatever the rules we are mentioning for the companies, they will follow all those rules. But some companies will not follow that. So that companies only, it will be suitability. Suitability in the meaning, it will be suitable only for the small trade companies, and it will be suitable for the partnership. So like this companies only it is suitable. It is not suitable for the large scale operation, because they will all follow the rules comes under the Indian Companies Act 2013. The last point is mixing up of personal and business transaction. I have told you already, sole trader or the partnership will follow this type of incomplete records. But mixing up of personal and business transaction is that I will mix up the personal expenses of the owner with the business transaction. So I cannot tell that whatever I have spent for myself, I will enter in my business also. So I cannot get the true and fair view of it. So this is all the features of the incomplete records. From the beginning, nature. Next is types of account maintained. We will maintain only cash and personal accounts of customer and the creditor. Next one is lack of uniformity. Uniformity in the meaning, we have a different level of organization, large scale, medium scale, small scale, but we have, whenever the accounts is not maintained properly, there will be no uniformity. The next is financial statements may not represent true and fair view. True and fair view in the meaning, have failed to record some information so that I cannot get the any statement in the proper way. Next one is suitability. Suitability in the meaning, it will be suitable only for the small sole trader or the partnership. It will not suitable for the joint stock companies. Next is mixing up of personal and business transaction. Personal and business transaction, in that I'll mix up my own expenses with the business transaction. So these are the features of the incomplete records. The next topic is limitations of incomplete records. The first topic is the lack of proper maintenance of records. Lack of proper maintenance of records in the meaning, they have not properly maintaining their accounts. They are not going to maintain accounts. I have told you, only they will maintain cash and personal accounts of the customers and creditors. The other accounts, they will leave it as it is. So there is not proper maintenance of the records itself. When we want to know what expenditure we made for the repairs or what expenditures we made for the other salaries given, we need to check, cross check with it. We don't have any records. Next one is difficulty in preparing trial balance. Many accounts we are not preparing. So in order to, when we come for the computations of the trial balance, we don't have sufficient information at all. Sufficient information is not there. We cannot calculate the trial balance. So it will always, wherever it will give you the correct information. It will give you only the error information. That is wrong information. Next one is difficulty in ascertaining true profitability of the business. True profitability of business is that if I have entered all those expenses and all those incomes in the books, I can get the correct exact net profit or the net loss. If I am not entering the expenses what I made properly, it will never give me a correct information. So that it will be very difficult to find the profitability of the business. Next one is difficulty in ascertaining financial position. Financial position in the meaning, I will enter only whatever I spend for the assets and liability. Whatever I have spent. Other expenses we have, we will enter in the assets, we will enter prepaid expenses, income accrued. All those expenses we will enter in the assets and liabilities. If I am not maintaining it properly, I will miss all those transactions or all those information. So that will not give me the correct financial position. The next one is errors and frauds cannot be detected easily. I myself failed to enter the transaction. So how I will be able to find the errors? Oh, I cannot able to find the errors. I have missed all those transactions. And frauds cannot be also detected easily. I missed the transaction. It can, if it is a fraud also, I cannot find it very easily. Because if I enter all those transactions, I can get the correct information from it. Next one is unacceptable to the government and the other authorities. Unacceptable to the government and other authorities in the meaning, I have not maintaining any records according to the government rules. If I am not maintaining the rule according to the rules, it will not be acceptable by the government. The government will require all those documents according to the government rules and regulation that comes under the section 128, subsection 1, Indian Companies Act 2013. If it is not maintained under a double entry system, the government will not accept it. These are the limitations, that is a drawback of the incomplete records. When I am maintaining a records incomplete, these are the limitations that I am facing. One is proper maintenance of records will be lagging. The other one is difficulty in preparing trial balance. When I prepare trial balance, I will face difficulty. Next one, difficulty in ascertaining the true profitability. Whether I am earning a net profit or net loss itself, I am finding it is very difficult. Next one is difficulty in ascertaining a financial position. Financial position I need to find. Difficulty in ascertaining financial position is also difficult because it will not give me the true value, because in the assets and liabilities I will miss some information. Next one is errors and frauds cannot be detected easily. I miss my the transaction, I cannot find the errors of frauds, whoever giving me the correct payment or not, I cannot judge it. Next one is unacceptable to the government and other authorities. If I want to pay the tax or not, I will not know the information correctly. And it has not been accepted by the government. Whenever I maintain all the complete records, it is acceptable. These are the limitations and the drawbacks of the incomplete records. In the next thing, we move on to the sums. That is a statement of profit and loss. Like that, we will see the sums now. Now we are going to see the calculations of a profit or loss through statement of affairs. This is the first problem that we calculate profit or loss from the information. I told you incomplete records will not give us the full information at all. Now we are going to prepare only with the what informations we are having. With that we need to find the profit or loss. First, capital at the end. Capital at the end is meaning is closing capital. At the year end, whatever the capital I have balance amount in my hand, that I will tell capital at the end or closing capital. Closing capital, it can be called in the other name, closing capital. Closing capital, capital at the end or the closing capital. Now, closing capital, what are the information they will take is, they will take all the assets and they will take all the liabilities information. Assets and liabilities, balance sheet we will use no. In the balance sheet, we will use assets and liabilities. All those informations, they will have it. And with that information, they will include all the other expenses also, like outstanding, prepaid. So like that, they will include all those informations. With that information, they calculate the capital at end. Drawings is nothing. Whatever the amount that taken by the proprietor for his personal use, we will take it as a drawings. Next, additional capital introduced at during the year, any capital is being the entry. Now, the additional capital introduced is nothing, whatever the amount being invested by the owner during the year. During the financial year, we have from April 1st to 31st March, whatever the amount being introduced in the middle or at the end, whatever time period, that we call it as the capital, additional capital introduced. Next is opening capital. Opening capital is nothing. Whatever the assets and liabilities values alone, asset and liabilities values alone, that is fixed assets, miscellaneous assets, like that assets value and liabilities, whatever the amount borrowed by from the bank or from the creditors, that alone we will take it as opening capital. So this, with this information, so no other additional information like outstanding, accrued income, like that we will not include anything. With that only information, the assets and liabilities alone we calculate as opening capital. Now we move on to the statement of affairs by calculating the profit or loss. This is the format for the calculations of the profit or loss. Capital at the end, that is closing capital, that you need to write the amount and you need to add drawings. Why we are adding drawing? Capital at the end, I will include all those expenses. So that if I add all those expenses, definitely in that time I will minus the drawings. So now in the opposite way, I am doing it addition so that it will give me the correct profit or loss. Next, additional capital introduced. Additional capital introduced, definitely it will increase our capital. But now I am going to subtract it because it will reflect it here on the balance sheet. So in order to avoid that, I am subtracting it. Next one is opening. Whenever I am subtracted, I will get the adjusted closing capital. At the last, if I subtract the opening capital, that at the beginning I have calculated now with only the assets and liabilities, if I subtract it, I will get the profit or loss. If the information is correctly given in this order, definitely everyone will feel easier to calculate the profit or loss. Now, I will teach you a very shortcut to learn this format. Because the format you will learn it in an easier way, and if it is given, all the information is being given correctly, and you need to find only this profit or loss, everyone will calculate easier. If any information is missing in between, if example, if a drawing amount they have not given you, they told you, they have given you profit, every information they have given you, but they failed to give the amount here and they told you to calculate, that time you will feel whether I should add the capital or I should subtract. You will feel the confusion because in the drawing area I don't have the amount. So you will have the confusion in calculating it. So I will teach you a very shortcut method to learn to whenever they have given the information in the middle. If it is missing, I will tell you one keyword, PAOLCD. This is my very short way of teaching you PAOLCD. That is PAO, Public Administrative Office is there, no? So that you can take it, or Public Accounts Office. We have some other thing linking to it. So you can have this keyword. Next, VCD, video cassette, we will have that. So in order, from the slightly variant as LCD. Okay, LED, LCD. So that you can learn this two keywords. If you learn these two keywords, the sum calculation in the middle, if any information is missing, you can calculate in the easier way.
Now see, what does the P stands for? Whenever they have given you the amount as profit, that you should write it here. Next, A. A stands for the additional capital. Now you can write this additional capital amount. Next, opening capital amount. You can write it here. Next, if it is profit is there, definitely loss will not be there. We all know that only one thing can occur in a year. Whether it can be profit or it can be a loss. Neither it cannot be a profit or loss. It would not be in the same situation that two cannot be at the same time also. So only you can have this profit or only you can have this loss alone. Now again, what does the C stands for? Closing capital. Closing capital amounts can be added on it. Next is drawing. Drawing amount, you can write it over here. Now, if any information, I have taking a small example, I don't have the information for additional, but I need to calculate the additional capital. Now, I'll write all those amount here. Profit amount, I am giving you 20,000. Let it be of 20,000. Now, opening capital, let it be of 10,000. So, this information only, I have it on the PAO. Now, LCD. LCD in the meaning, I will not have profit I have given. So, loss will not be there. Now only C and D. C is closing capital. Let it be of 50,000. Now let me take off for drawings. Let it amount be 10,000. So when I add, I'll get the answer of 60,000 on the LCD. That is loss, closing capital, drawing. On the PAO, that is I'll get the answers of 30,000 as the what? PAO value. Okay, this is only will be your value. Now, after adding these two separately, if you find the difference, that is minus it, you will get the answer of missing term. If I minus it 30,000, 60,000, so the balance 30,000 will be my additional capital. Additional capital will be 30,000. This is all, you can find it out whenever the information being given in the middle. But keep it in your mind, don't use this method in your exam answer paper. You should follow this method only. For calculation of this, you can do it in the rough sheet at the end of the paper. So that it will be helpful to find the missing term in between. Don't avoid the confusion whether I need to add or sub or what confusion you will have at the time of exam. That confusion can be avoided. If after doing it, write it over here. And if you write it over here, now capital at the end, I have given the capital at the end of the value of 50,000. 50,000. Now drawings, I have given the value of 10K. When I add this, I will get the answer of 60K. Now additional capital being 30K. Now the opening capital value is 10,000. When I difference find 60,000 minus 30,000, I'll get the value of 30,000 because I need to subtract out the additional capital. After that, I'll get the adjusted closing capital value of 30,000. After writing it on the opening capital 10,000, if I find the subtracted value, I'll get the 20,000 as my profit. Because I'm getting the positive value, so it always says that it is profit. If I get the answer, profit. Profit I have given only 20,000 at the question itself. So this is how you can do it in your exam sheet. This format, it is there only you can get full marks. It is only for your calculation confusion. I am giving you this shortcut. So capital at the end you need to write, and you need to write this value on the format, and you need to do it in such a way. For your calculation, you can do it on the rough sheet. You need to very well keep it in your mind, this three keywords, key letters, PAO, LCD. One profit is there, loss definitely will not be there. When loss is there, definitely profit will not be there. PAO, additional, opening, LCD, loss, closing, drawings. This is the information you need to calculate in the rough sheet. And you can calculate in the format and find the calculations of profit or loss through statement of affairs. This is the sum and this end of the sum. We will move on to how to calculate closing capital and opening capital. That and all we will do it on the next session. Thanks for watching.